thumbs up. The blue side is giving me the thumbs up as well. Our referees say we're good to go. We're going to kick it off then with Auton in 3, 2, 1, go! All right, Ear Slingers doing the same thing we saw in finals match number one. They've got those tri-balls. They're launching them, sending them bowling down the alley over towards that red offensive zone. Meanwhile, Boilers with a similar strategy as well, sending those tri-balls bowling down that blue alleyway over towards that blue offensive zone. It's a 24-inch bot for Boilers, heading towards that blue goal with a huge pile of tri-balls. Both of those robots short enough to fit into that blue goal to make sure those tri-balls are scored securely there. 15 seconds to go. CP slow. They have an opportunity now with a big pile of tri-balls. They're going to send those tumbling into that red goal as well. 7 seconds left, and here comes Boilers with another pile of tri-balls behind them, and they're in that blue goal. 5 points apiece for all of these tri-balls in those goals. Blue appears to have more in the goal, but there's a lot of tri-balls on the floor as well. We're going to need to tabulate this one and be careful. It could be pretty close. And Auton will go to blue. 8 points in favor of BLRS2. Let's resume now with driver control in 3, 2, 1, go. All right, we have all four robots zooming here in the driver control period. CP slow trying to grab a huge pile of 5 tri-balls and send it over towards that red goal. They're getting caught up though by BLRS2, their 15-inch bot. It's both of these 15-inch bots battling over that red goal. Boiler's gonna back away, gonna send a couple of tri-balls over that central elevation barrier to their partner, the 24-inch bot that's over there. And CP slow sends the 15-inch robot packing all the way back over toward the blue goal, shoving them into the blue goal. 47 seconds still to play. CP slow with their 24-inch bot heading back over to score in that red goal. Boiler's trying to shove them into that wall, trying to grab that match load. That match load being defended though by CP slow, but it looks like Boilers are able to break through the defense. And let's see if they can pick up that match load as well. 30 seconds now on the clock. Boilers trying to steal from both of these match loads at the same time. They're double zoning over on that red side, but they back away now and double zone on the offensive side for them. 2 more try balls into that blue goal. Now with less than 20 seconds to play, the goals are looking pretty even. CP slow trying to turn the match in their favor with another try ball in the red goal. 12 seconds left. Let's see if we can get any elevations. We're focusing on the try balls though. CP slow, they're going to send their 24-inch robot over towards that central elevation barrier. Boilers steals a try ball over towards the blue goal with 2 seconds left. Purdue trying to hang, but that bot not getting off the ground. We do have 2 red bots in the air, 1 blue bot in the air. This is almost the exact opposite of the end of match number one. All right, Grant, I'd love to know what you thought about that match.
Honestly, I thought pretty similar to what you did. The way, you know, blue was, you know, commanding lead for a little bit, but red was, you know, pushing really hard. And then the way it ended, 2 red robots, 1 blue robot, it almost looked like both alliances kind of, I don't want to say freaked out, but they kind of started making some snap decisions in those last 10 seconds to either defend or pin or score one more or go climb. And as we were talking about earlier with the middle school divisions, you know, those split-second decisions are what can make or break your match.